Welcome back. So today we're doing do I'm doing we're doing a flight from Madeira Municipal Airport in the US of A. So we're going from Madeira, California to Bakersfield. It isn't that such a long flight, but we're using the default flight plan. So it's gonna be exciting. I put on air traffic, AI traffic, so there should be other airplanes in the area, which means that there will be traffic and we need to listen to the ATC. So let's get this plane started. This is the Robin DR401. It's a default airplane, which was a gift from Aerobasque. It's a 155 CDI diesel engine, so we need to wait a little bit when starting the engine. So first go battery. We're gonna fix the failures. Fix all systems. Done. Apply changes. I think it's because the autopilot isn't on, so we're going Oakland area. There we go. And we'll turn on the alternator, master switch, fuel pump. Wait for that to preheat. What did, oh yeah, fuel. There we go. Okay, so now this can come off. Avionics on. We're gonna prepare a flight plan. This is gonna be KMIA. There we go. Then delete this whole flight plan because we don't need it. Basically, what we're gonna do is go direct to Pond. So B. O. N. Bond and then direct to L45. Four, five. There we go. And now we need to file a flight plan. So this is all on. We can turn on nav lights. We go here, file flight plan. No, we don't need that. This is our aircraft identification, and we're gonna go to Robin. Then our type, which isn't really, so we're gonna do Dauphin 22 or the DR400 Dauphin 4, that's better. Our en route altitude is going to be 8,000, and we're going to L45, direct to Pond. File flight plan. That's good. Set our flaps. We're just gonna, so there's no air tower here, so we're just gonna take off and then request our clearance. So we're gonna be taking off from runway 26, just so we have a little bit of fun. So let's go. Flashlights is our that. So, release the parking brake, which is here. For our auto, we'll engage the autopilot, we'll prepare it. So, heading mode. This way. Then our heading is going to be 257. Two, five, seven. There you go. Yaw dampener. I know where you can turn that on. Or this one doesn't have it. That can also all be true. Turn on all the lights. Pitch trim is good. Rudder trim is also good. So then we're going to set our altitude to what did we say? 8,000, right? Give me a second. We're gonna do this joystick. Oh, that's Copilot. Okay, so we need MFD. MFD. Outer ring. MFD outer altitude up, and the same with this one. Where is it? Altitude and down. There we go. So now we're good. There we go. So we're gonna do flight level change. Well, first this. There's no yaw dampener. Doesn't look like it. So we're just gonna take off so flashlight can come on. We'll turn pitot heat on. So we're just gonna do a rolling start. Isn't this 2.6? Yeah, that's two, this is 2.6. There we go. So now we go again here. And now we'll do nav mode. So there's no yaw dampener. Too far. There we go. These can go back up. Coming. There we go. Nav mode. Let's see, these lights are off, which basically are these ones here. We have our fuel is full, so there's no left or right. There's a center tank and there's the right tank. So basically every sort of minutes we need to do this to fill the main tank. Because this is the auxiliary tank, so there's no. This can go away. There's two. L45. Bakersfield. Don't know what approach, so not yet. Arrival, there aren't one. There isn't one. So this is the airport where we're flying to. It's a little airport. So yeah, approaches. We'll build them both just in case. There we go. One five four. Just in case. And the same with this one. Just in case. And now we're at 8,000 feet, so we can put the throttle down to cruise. So here. And it's gonna be sort of like 100 knots, 100 knots. So slow. But still, it's a cool airplane. It's free, it's a free airport. Flying. BFD. This one, there's one. So there's no anti-ice on thing on this airplane. There's only pedo heat. So should be fun. Fadek is here. But no, there's only one anti-ice system, and that's the pedo heat. So now the only thing we need to do is enjoy it. See if we can go inside of the screen and see what's behind it. So here's nothing. And here's nothing either. Okay. So we're flying heading 1-4. So we're going good. So we're gonna put our altimeter to standard, which is here. No, it's no, I don't know. XPDR alt. I know I'm trying. Code 4700 XPDR alt. There we go. Batteries in the green. This is good. RPM is just on the green, but it's good. It's all green. This is all good. Let's see what happens if we go back to nav. What I love about this plane is this a lot of glass. It can look around quite good, even down. And it doesn't have retractable gear. So yeah, it's fun. It's a fun little airplane. Turn out the radio sound. Sound radio done. There's another airport, a private one. Sierra Sky Park. So it's a little airplane community. This one is a little bit bigger. I see a FedEx. It's cool. There's another one. This is a general aviation airport, so a private one too. We're gonna transfer a little bit of fuel, so open this. It will start to rise. And then close it again. There we go. Here you can see flight hours, even though I don't think it's not a correct way. These don't. With the Diamond DA62, you can click on the. Or was it a TBM? It was the Hot Start TBM 900. You could click on this and it would turn down the outside sounds. So those black dots are the other airplane. So I don't have prepared the arrival yet, but that's because we don't know this. We don't know the approach. So we don't know what the active runway is. Just to let them know that we're still here. So we're still at 57 miles to go. Let's see, shift six. What I also like about the Robin DR401 are these wings. They're not straight, but they're like curved. That's really cool. So we're going good. We're at 8,000 feet, and we're going to Pond, and after Pond to Bakersfield Municipal Airport, which is quite nice. We're also waiting for air traffic control. So, yeah, the only thing we can do now is just sit back, relax, and enjoy the flight until air traffic control is calling us. There should be a way to click on the joystick and then make it so that you can talk. I still need to find out how. There's one over here. Where is it? AV tab? No. So that's not it. Let's see. No, that's all good. That's cool. Train radar. And we don't need the aircraft because we got it right here. Let's see. See if we can plan our arrival. So this is the VOR one is for runway. Where's the airport? Oh, there. Runway 34. And this is for also for runway 34. Okay, so we're gonna do RNAV or VOR. Let's do RNAV. I deleted the one I needed. Approach RNAV. And this one can go away. So we need the. We go here. And then go to L45 procedures. Now we can go to bond. And then procedures, select approach, and we're doing the RNAV. There we go. Let's see. We're gonna do the VOR one. Clear. Flight plan, procedure, approach, and the VOR from Wogik. Minimums 378. Oh, clear. VR one, Wogik. Three seven. Enter load. So if you go to flight plan, what we now need to do is put here the L45. If not, it will fail, as we've seen before. But I still don't know why it puts it down there. L45, enter. And this one clear. There we go. It does show like it's not going anywhere, but don't worry. I've tried before and it works perfectly. It's a little bit weird, that's the only thing. We'll turn on the auxiliary tank again, just in case. Turn terrain on. What do I want to do? Welcome. So today we're flying from Madera Municipal Regional Airport in California or Oakland. Don't remember why, but okay. Here, Oakland Area Control to Bakersfield Municipal Airport, which if you look here at the map, we're almost there. Well, almost, I shouldn't say almost, but we're close. Let's just say that. And we're flying in the Robin DR-401 freeware airplane from Aerobasque. I chose this one because it's quite cool. I like the color. Like that it's blue. I actually think if you change the outside, it also changes the inside. So, and we're also using the default ATC, which is this one over here, this window. And we're basically following our flight plan to Bond and listening onto ATC so we can fly sort of realistic. If we actually want to fly realistic, we need to use VATSIM or Pilot Edge, which are the best air traffic controls plugins for X-Plane 11. But yeah, it's quite simple actually. So you go here, click the headphone type of thing, file your flight plan. If you prepare it, it's easy. You type in your whole route with airways and everything, and then request flight plan, and you just do it as always, request your clearance. Request taxi, everything else. We're going cruise. We're in cruise mode, so that's 103 knots per mile. I don't know. We're going 103 knots. True airspeed is 115 knots, which is calculated with the pitot heat. I don't see any icing. I don't even know how to see look for it on this airplane. But we'll see. We just need to go, wait and see. We're almost at our destination, which means we can almost commence our approach. Which is quite cool. So yeah. And today I don't have any music, so we'll do that next time because I'm basically waiting for the ATC. So maybe next time I should add more AI airplanes and we'll see what happens. Maybe that should help. That we'll have a video for tomorrow. And we're starting our descent, people. Radio speed, nose down. One six, 5,000. We've started our descent, people. So we're descending to 3,200, even if they said 5,000. Heading 10, 5,000. That's where we're going. Let's see if they can take us to the runway correctly. So if we look here. There we go, 5,000. We actually have around 7,000 pounds of fuel. I mean, 7 hours of fuel, but it doesn't look that bad. So I've put this for the VOR, but I think if we continue asking for what they say, it's going good, I think. So nav, let's see what they say about that. We can just go back to heading and nothing is going on. We're just following our flight plan. I think around here, I'll put up flaps 1, and then when we're here, flaps 2. So here's the airport. Doesn't show here because it's a little one. But yeah, it's a municipal airport, not an international one. So we're maintaining 5,000 feet, heading 184, even though to say 16. We still string or what's happening? Sorry, funny video. So we're flying on heading 175. They said to us 160, but we're sort of following our flight, the route they said, so they're not saying anything to us. There we go. We're almost at our destination. We're flying to Bakersfield Municipal Airport. As you can see here, we're almost at our approach. If we look here, you'll see the same. We're going from Wojcik, weird name, but yes, Wojcik, to our runway. We're at 5,000. And now we're waiting for them to tell us where, if we need to descend, maintain our course of heading, and see what's happening. We still have more than enough fuel for landing. Lights are good. Flash and nav lights are on. And these two are the landing lights, which are weird, but if I show you, these lights work for the outside, this too. So if I turn one on, that one turns on, and two, that one. They're a little bit weird at night. I tried using them once, and it's a little bit weird, I gotta say. Let's see if we can find our airport. I think that. No, that's not it. Let's see. I think we're too far away still. Think we're still far too far away. Oh well. Maintaining 5,000. Good core. Virtual speed. And 1,000. We're descending 1100 feet per minute. Let's go back to cruise. There we go. We're almost at 3,000 feet. We need to send to 2,000. As requested by ATC. It's now behind us. 1,000 feet to go. Yeah, I still don't see it from here. Or is it there? No. We'll see it when we get there. Is it doing automatic? Yes, it is. I know, I'm trying. It stopped doing it. Turn on one landing light. We need to go to 2,000 feet. There's no altitude. There we go. We're holding 2,000 feet. We're at our approach thingy. I still can't see the airport, which is weird. We should already have visual, but okay. I'll go flaps one. We're on one set of flaps. Sorry for that. I needed to turn on the light. We're gonna do it in a curve, so we're still going to the same waypoint, but a different way. It's saying us to go direct to Subni instead of making this beautiful curve. So instead of going like this, it says for us to go like this, which isn't actually useful, but okay. This can go off. I don't need it. So, that's right. Inside said aircraft. I now found it out. It says Arabesque over here. That way you can see it's what I said it was. It's a free Arabesque plane. I still don't see the goddamn airport. Still don't see it. So we've got airport approach flaps, and when we get here, we'll turn on our second set of flaps, which is our landing flaps. I know I'm saying too much flaps, so yeah. I have no idea where that airport is. So we need to watch there, sort of. I don't see it. We'll find it eventually. It's not here, that's for sure. It's not this one. That's too small. That's 81C Ka. Charlie Alpha. That's 81 Charlie Alpha, which is not our airport. That's for sure. We got another one over here. It's a Cessna Skyhawk. Where am I? There I am. Flaps are down. Bitterweed is still on because we need it. There's no alerts, so that's good. Maybe it's there. I have no idea. There is a plane over there. So it might be that, or it might be this. 7 Charlie Alpha 2. That might be what's in those trees. Where was it? There. So that means my airport is somewhere over there, which I still don't have visual. Well, that's okay. Gonna live it a bit more power. Turn on the terrain radar. Seriously. Wait for a second. There. Are you sure that's a good way to do that? Think it's better to go to nav again. Wait, that's not it. It's VNav. That's what I mean. We're going back to our route and then take this one. It's a little bit weird, but yeah. We exceed 146. Well, we're good. We're 1-2. That's not it. I don't want to be mean, but I still don't have visual on the runway. I know it's there somewhere. The question is where? Or is that it? That could be it. I think that's it. But it should be over here. We'll see. This airport is also cool. I have no idea how you get that, how you land there, but okay. Oh, it's with taxiways over there. Okay. Cool. What is 070? There we go. I think that's the airport. No idea why it says this way, but okay. The runway's over here. We're gonna align ourselves with the runway, 'cause this is not helping. Think that's why it's called a VOR. Visual on runway. Cancel that. This is runway 34. Flaps are set. And there we go. Welcome to Bakersfield. Flashlights can come off. We're going all the way here to the back. Welcome to Bakersfield, guys. Go here. And take this one over here. There we go. Set parking brake. And first we're gonna watch a replay. So, replay mode. I think this was a great landing, seriously. Here we go. Better than usual, actually, because we touched down exactly went a little bunny hop, but great landing, like it. See, now we got a butter. Okay, so CDI can go to GPS. We'll clear the flight plan. There we go. Landing light, this can come off. That's off. And turn our avionics off. And turn our master engine switch. And that's our engine. Turn our fuel off. And yeah, our battery. So that's it. That's it for today, guys. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.